There are three different ways to create realistic AI avatars with Synthesia.
From static hosts with removable backgrounds,
to fully customizable presenters that perform literally any action.
And you can even make a clone of yourself that is so lifelike that nobody will ever know it's not real. To make your first avatar video right now, follow the link in the description to head over to Synthesia. And once you're in the dashboard, there are a few different ways to get started. But first, I'm going to open up the avatars menu in the bottom left, where you can see just how many different Synthesia avatars you have to choose from. But the newest update to the Synthesia library is the ability to put your avatar into any outfit or location that you describe. You can even make your avatar act out full scenes for your videos.
That's right. I'm the best way to engage your audience because you can put me directly into the context of your video, letting you make videos that actually show, not just tell.
Back in the main dashboard, you're going to see this banner for avatars that take action. So if I get started, it's going to open up the Synthesia editor where it's already added a custom avatar onto the canvas for me. Now, this current avatar would work well for a corporate video, but like I said, I can fully customize the outfit or location to anything that I describe. Just select the avatar on the canvas, and using this pop-up menu just above, I can go ahead and change the avatar to any of these six customizable characters. And now I can create any outfit for them just by typing a description into the box. So let's say I want to see this avatar wearing a white lab coat and goggles. And as you can see, it's gone ahead and created that for me. You can even mention specific color codes to fit your company's branding. So let's say I want to see my avatar dressed like a racing driver, and the overalls are going to be in Synthesia blue, which is this color code that I've added at the end of the prompt. I can hit create and it's generated that too. So I can go ahead and add that straight into my scene. Now, as you can see, this new costume doesn't really match the background, so I can go ahead and customize the setting too. I'll go to select space, then create space. And this works in the exact same way as generating an outfit. I just need to type in any description, hit create, and there we go. It's made a new location. And Synthesia actually saves all of the outfits and locations that you generate in this list, so you can go back and change to one of them at any time. But now I want to hear my avatar talk, and all I need to do is type or paste a script into this box at the bottom, and I can hear a preview of what it's going to sound like straight away by pressing play.
Today, I'm going to walk you through the safety procedures for when you're trackside for the big race.
Now, don't panic that the avatar didn't move. This is just a preview within the editor, and I'm going to show you how to export the full final version later on in this video. But now, I want to make my host act out a full scene for this video. In that same pop-up menu, select Create Media, and once again, I just need to describe any action that I want to see my avatar perform. And as you can see, it's already going to feature my custom avatar and scene. Just be as detailed as possible with your description, hit the generate button, and in just a few minutes, it's going to create my clip. So my full custom avatar video could end up looking something like this.
Today, I'm going to walk you through the safety procedures for when you're trackside for the big race. We work in a fast-paced environment, so it's not just the drivers who need to think about safety. This is a team sport, where everybody needs to step up.
But the great thing about Synthesia is that there are different avatar styles to suit different types of video, and you can even create full projects based on a document that you already have. From the dashboard once again, I'm going to select New Video, where I can choose from any avatar template to get started. And if I hover over one that I like and select Create with AI, I can then upload any existing document to create an entire video based on that existing content. So this is going to be especially useful when you're making videos for work. But I can also link to any web page that I want to make a video from. I can write a detailed prompt for what I want to see, or I can just add my own script. But for this example, I'm going to go ahead and add a Word document from my computer. Just underneath, you'll also see the option to add your own company brand kit, which is going to update any of the selected templates with your approved fonts and colors that you've added before. Right at the bottom, you can also specify the video length and some other details if you like, and then I'll go ahead and select Create Outline. And the AI is now going to go ahead and pull out all of the information from that Word document and write me a summary of each chapter in the video. So if I open one of them up, you'll see some bullet points inside, and I can go ahead and add some more information to this list if I like. I can even delete some bullet points if I think they're not needed, or I can delete an entire chapter. When I'm happy with the overview, I can select Create Video, and I'll now get an entire preview showing me what each scene in the video is going to look like, as well as the avatar script right next to it. So if I don't like the look or design of any scene, I can still go ahead and replace the layout to another option from the templates. And when I'm happy, I can either go ahead and generate the final video straight away, or I can open it up inside the video editor to make some more changes. And at this point, I can still change the avatar presenter for this video. All I need to do is select the one on the screen right now, and on the right-hand side, I can pick from any of the other options in the library. I can also click to customize any of the text on screen, and I can move anything that I see to anywhere I want within the frame.
Cyber threats are not just headlines. They're a daily reality for businesses of all sizes.
But for a real personal touch, Synthesia also lets you create an AI clone of yourself, so you can make videos at any time, in any place, without ever picking up a camera. In fact, that wasn't me talking to you just now. That was my personal avatar doing the work for me. Back in the avatars menu, go to the personal avatar option at the top and hit create. Now, this video on screen is going to guide you through some of the best practices for recording your avatar, and if we hit next, you'll have two different options for doing that recording. You can read a short script directly into your webcam, which is the easiest option, but it's also a bit more limiting in terms of quality and location. So I tend to recommend uploading 1 to 5 minutes of pre-recorded footage instead. You can just record yourself talking about any topic that you like and upload the final video right here. Just make sure the video itself is in one continuous take with no cuts. The longer you speak for and the more expressions and emotions that you use during the recording, the better the final result is going to be. Just make sure you don't cover your face at any time, including with your hands, and make sure you include a few pauses along the way as well. But for this example, I'm going to go back one step and use my webcam. And on this next page here, you're going to see a preview of what your recording is going to look like. To get the best possible quality, I do recommend connecting a DSLR or a mirrorless camera if you have one, and the same goes with your audio. If you can use a professional microphone, it's going to give you results that are 10 times better than an internal laptop microphone. And you can select your video and audio inputs underneath the video preview right here. If I hit next, we can now take a look at the script that you'll be recording. Now, don't worry, you don't need to memorize anything. When you press record, the script is going to scroll up on the screen like a TV teleprompter. And before that, you can also change the language of the script at the top of the screen, and you can also control the scroll speed at the bottom. And before you press record, I do recommend reading it through a couple of times just to get familiar with the words so you can read it more naturally. And you'll also notice some scripted pauses in there as well, so you definitely need to make sure to pay attention to those. When you're ready, hit start recording. You'll get a 3-second countdown, and it takes around 2 minutes to read through the whole thing. If you stumble over your words or make a mistake, you can hit record again in the top left, and when you're done, you can submit your recording. I recommend reviewing your performance on this next page to see if the eye contact is good and the audio is clear, and I can now choose if I want the background removed from my avatar, which can be a good option, but I want mine to look like my normal recording setup right here. And before we can process your avatar, you do need to film a short consent video so Synthesia has permission to make your clone. Just like before, you'll get a 3-second countdown and the script scrolls up on the screen. You then have one more box to tick for biometric consent. Hit submit your recording and your footage will be uploaded for generation, which takes around 24 hours. You'll get an email when it's ready to use, and you'll be able to choose your personal avatar in the exact same way as the other avatars in the library. So now you're done creating and you're ready to export and share your video. From the editor, hit generate in the top right and go ahead and give your project a name if you haven't already. At this point, you can also choose if you want some burnt-in subtitles to be included on the video, and you can also give some names to your chapter headings if you want to. Then hit generate and your video will start to render, which can take a little while if it's a longer video. But once it's finished, you can go ahead and watch the final version on this page, where you have a few other options as well. First, you can translate your video into any language with lip sync, so it will look like your avatar is native to your target audience. Just select translate at the top of the screen and select as many languages as you want from the drop-down menu. They'll all generate at the same time. Now, if you only want the avatar speech to be translated and not the text on screen, you need to select this button right here. And if you select this next option underneath, it can automatically export your videos without returning to the editor. So I'm going to go ahead and tick that one today. And in a few minutes, you'll find all of your translations in the dashboard right here. Now, before you send your video out into the world, there might be some people who need to check your work or collaborate on it with you. And Synthesia makes that really easy to do. Select this button at the top right here and just add the email addresses of any person that you want to send the video to. And you can also select their level of access from this menu. Then hit invite and it will send them an email to accept your invitation. So depending on what access you've given them, they can leave comments on this draft or even go into the editor and make some changes themselves. And if you want to learn how to make fully interactive videos with clickable options on the screen, you should watch this video on screen right now.